Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the review, because one of my followers was asking if I could do a review or a comparison between the first version of the Canon EF 24-105mm f4L, you see that because of the red wing, Mark 1 version, and here is the successor. It's the 24-105mm f4L IS-2 USM. If we look from above on both lenses, what we see, if you require a filter, you need a 77mm filter size. Comparing the size of both lenses, you see directly that the first version is a bit smaller than the Mark II version. That's the Mark I version. So you have an indication of the minimum focus distance. The closest focusing distance is 0.45 meters, that's 1.5 feet. Two switches, autofocus, manual focus, and image stabilizer on and off. And that's it. The zoom ring has a nice and pleasant resistant, so as the focus ring. But to be honest with you, it feels a bit old, but the lens is old. That's it, yeah. So apart from that, there are no other switches or dials or rings around it, but the overall build quality, nice and solid. Here's the Mark II version. First of all, what you're gonna see is that the zoom and the focus ring are much bigger on the Mark II version than on the Mark I version. It's kind of hard to zoom with that lens, and focus-wise, it's more soft if you use the manual focus. Additionally, you have a lock switch to lock the zoom. On this side, autofocus, manual focus, image stabilizer on and off, and an indication of the closest focusing distance, which is the same on this one here, 0.45 meters, that's 1.5 feet. Comparing both lenses side by side, the Mark I version does not feel as, I would say, solid as the Mark II version, but it's much lighter. So you can really feel it if you have both of these lenses side by side. And of course, it's a bit smaller than the Mark II version. Let's start the review with all the annoying things on these two lenses. When I looked through the photos, I did not really see too many chromatic aberrations. These are the magenta and green color stitches around the edges. The new version is slightly better than the old one, but that should not be the reason for the purchase. Looking at vignetting is almost the same. If you don't know what vignetting is, these are the dark corners that appear when shooting at a fast aperture. Both lenses have these dark corners at f4, and both lenses have an improve in performance at f6.3. But folks, don't waste your time and energy when it comes to vignetting. At the end, Adobe Lightroom will fix it anyways, in a more simple way than you think. There must be the reason to spend 600 euros more for the new version. Maybe when it comes to these lens flares. Let's see, pointing these lenses directly into the sun. Damn, as you can see, there are a lot of lens flares. The new version seems to perform a bit better than the old one, but in general, I would say that I've never seen so many lens flares on any Canon prime lens. If you like close-ups, you can get as close as 45 centimeters, which is only 18 inches to your subject, through the entire focal length. I wish I could have been able to be a bit closer with the new version, but anyways, you can get stunning results with both lenses, especially when using a full-frame camera like the Canon EOS 5D Mark IV. However, the bokeh, which is the blur background while shooting at a fast aperture, is stunning on both lenses. A big point goes to the new version with its 10 aperture blades instead of 8 aperture blades on the old version. Using a camera like the Canon EOS 6D Mark II, 5D or 1DX will give you a stunning blur background and a great sharpness at the same time. Anyways, if you have an APS-C sensor camera, the bokeh will be okay, but not as cool as on a full frame body. So what's next? We'll now take a look on the focus speed of both lenses. We noticed that the new version is a bit faster than the old version. You probably don't really notice the difference anyways. But if you require a fast and precise focus as a press or sport photographer, we would say that the 24-105 Mark II is a great choice for your camera bag. On the other side, the AF speed depends also on the camera you're using, and we had the feeling that the focus was more precise with the Canon EOS 5D Mark IV than with the new Canon EOS 6D Mark II for the same shot. I bet some of you were looking for a great all-rounder for one of Canon's full-frame DSLRs. One of these lenses may be the right choice for you. The overall performance in terms of distortion is great on both lenses. Standing in front of the Empire State Building will give you for sure the impression that the tower is falling into the background. But in general, there is not too much of a difference in terms of distortion around the edges between both lenses. But that's all about buying one of Canon's prime lenses for a great performance. One of the major improvements on the new version of the Canon 24-105mm is the enhanced image stabilizer, which allows you to shoot up to 4 stops slower than normal. That's important during hours of darkness, if you don't want to push the ISO too high. I enjoyed using the new image stabilizer for video recording. The footage looked more smooth than with the old version while I was shooting the clips handheld. If you require the better image stabilizer, consider getting the new version for your work than the old one. Just before we come to the end of this review, we will take a look on the most important aspect when considering the purchase of one of these lenses. The sharpness plays a major role, especially with a price difference of almost 700 euros. For this test, we used the old and the new version on the Canon EOS 5D Mark IV at 3 different locations. I have no idea how much time I spent in front of Lightroom to see any difference between those two. In fact, I did not see the need for the new version so far. In the center, they are both doing a great job. The sharpness is extremely good. Taking a look at the edges, you will notice that the new version is slightly better than its predecessor. For us, it seemed to be that both lenses were performing almost the same at f6.3. I don't know if it has something to do with my camera or the lens itself, but in fact, I did not change any settings on my camera. I had the impression that the colors looked more beautiful and natural on the old version than on the new version. Dark was dark on the old lens, and dark was almost black on the new version. Make up your own mind, these files are available for private use, the link is below. That's about it, folks. I think that both lenses do fantastic jobs in reliability, sharpness and durability. I've been using my old 24-105mm for a couple of years now. First on the 5D Mark II, then on the Mark III, and now on the 5D Mark IV. It helped me to take great photos and videos for all kinds of projects. It's one of the best all-rounders for full-frame bodies, and it can be used on all Canon APS-C sensor cameras as well. If you're not 100% satisfied with the quality, why not getting the new version? I know the difference, so far as I could see, was not too big. The image stabilizer helped me to take more steady shots during video recording, and it allowed me to use a longer shutter during hours of darkness. In terms of sharpness, I think that the difference is not too big to say that it's worth getting the new version, if you have already the old version in your pocket. Have you been using any of these lenses on your camera and for your projects? I'm happy to hear from you. Leave a comment below. What do you personally think about the difference? Did I forget to mention something that you think would have been important to say? If yes, let me and the other followers know. Thanks for your time. If you are in Frankfurt one day, make sure to stop at the best camera store near the airport, GM Photo. Thanks to Fabian for filming, Canon Germany for the lens, and you for watching. Tschüss aus Frankfurt am Main und bis bald. Tschüss.